So today we are doing something interesting. Well, we're doing quite interesting stuff actually for the past few days, but today we are going to Burgundy. We're gonna visit Auntie Odile, or is it Edith? I think it's Odile and George in the house, country house in Burgundy. So that's like south of France, southwest I think. So right now we're just at the station grabbing our breakfast at a pit stop. And then we'll go back on the train and we'll reach there in about 20 more minutes.
Croissant, chocolate croissant and a sandwich.
And I forgot to bring my camera. So if you guys were wondering why like yesterday's footage was just lunch and then dinner, because in between I went and got a new phone, and it is the Note 4. Yeah, it was super expensive, so don't ask me how much it was, because I'm just gonna eat like grains of rice for like the next 7 months. That's how expensive it was. But I needed one and I wanted the Note 4, so I just got it. Hopefully I don't lose this one anytime soon. We are on the train and I think we are about to arrive. So this is the scenery outside, the countryside. And this is inside the train.
Mesdames et messieurs, dans quelques instants, notre TER entre en gare de Chagny. Pour votre sécurité, veuillez attendre l'arrêt complet du train à quai avant d'en descendre. Prochain arrêt, Chagny.
Chagny, the stop. So we're here and we're gonna go. And we are in Isabel's mom's house and Uncle George. They picked us up from the train, and this is the garage, and that's
Amelia.
Yeah. And that's the wine presser from her grandfather many years ago. And this house is the garage, but I'll show you guys outside later. Mm-hmm. This house was from Isabel's grandparents,
or great grandparents.
It's passed down from generation to generation, and it's amazing. It's so nice. So we're gonna go in, and I'll see you guys later.
Oh no, she's in the garden.
Yeah.
You got George, Jardin. Oh,
Belle.
Bonjour.
Nice to see you.
Oui.
Oh,
la petite famille. Bonjour.
C'est du bon.
Alors, je vais dire en anglais. I am happy to see you.
Again. I am very happy to see you
again.
Ça va bien?
Oui.
Oui.
And Uncle George is cooking. I can't speak French or English. I cut some potatoes,
beef.
Odile made freshly made cheese buns. Very nice. Uncle George got us oysters today. So nice. Look at all that, guys. So yesterday we had tons of oysters, and today we're having more. But I guess I don't mind, because it looks pretty good. George and Auntie Edith love to travel, and this is their list of all the places they've been. I don't know if it's opposite or not, but so I'm gonna stop. But there's like from 1993 to 2014, they've been traveling every year, and so this is the list. China, Canada. I probably know them. Yeah, Vietnam. I met them when they came here last year.
Office.
So this is the living room. Yeah. It used to be many years ago.
But you see, no, they don't really live here, so that's why it's a bit of a mess everywhere.
Yeah. Who's
this? These are my grandparents on their wedding days.
Wow.
My grandmother and my grandfather.
This one?
This is my mother's sister, Edith's mum.
Ah.
And this is my sister who died. And so that's another painting my mum made, which I loved. She gave it to me and it's still here. I have to
take it
back. This is the kitchen. My mom stores all her plants such here. A, I love her apples.
Yeah. Where do you apples from the?
Yeah, from the garden.
The garden from outside.
The garden here. Yeah. Uh-huh. You see. So it's more a storage place. This is a bedroom, but there are my brothers and my daughter's stuff here, all piled up.
Storage.
It used to be a bedroom. My mum drew that as well. You have her painting.
What is this all?
The scenery from Antilles, I think. You see, with the island and the boats.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Such a nice place.
It is.
Like, is this the guest room?
This
or
is the
your...
guest room, yes.
Okay.
This is where I sleep when I come here.
And I you got a good view?
We call it the blue room.
It's a nice room.
Mm.
This is the backyard?
Yeah, that's the garden. And the cherry trees.
That one? Is that the cherry tree?
Yeah, three cherry trees.
That's nice. So Isabel's gonna show me the cellars right now. Ooh, we gotta bend down.
So all these are bulbs, you know, from flowers that George will plant later on.
Okay.
So this is one part of the cellar where Mum keeps all her jams.
That is cool. That's really cool.
And all the cherries and fruits and
all this from
beans.
The garden. And
yeah,
stuff?
All this from the garden. Yes.
Do you buy things from the market and then? Make
no,
them?
Very little. George does most of it.
See? So this is raspberry jam.
Raspberry, tomatoes, cherries, strawberries.
Wow.
Strawberries, more strawberries. Yes,
a lot of strawberry
jam. Pumpkins from the garden too.
Mm-hmm.
Here are.
And all these empty bottles to make the wine.
Yeah, Or souvenirs, maybe they're more souvenirs, I think.
What is this?
Oh, this used to be maybe for the cheese, I think.
Cheese?
But it's not used anymore.
How do they?
They would keep the cheese in so and to prevent the flies to go
okay,
on.
Okay.
You see, and it gets some air.
Nice. So how long do all these, like, food last?
Oh, years! Oh, there are des figues. Tiens, je vais prendre des figues, moi. Oh, yes, I'm gonna take one of these.
Fig jam?
Yes, fig.
So many.
Quince.
Are those olives?
Cherries.
Cherries.
And plums, I think. These must be plums from the garden, cherries from the gardens, and beans from the gardens, too. And these may be plums.
Wow.
Yeah,
the wine cellar.
Summer kitchen.
What? So you guys cook here in the summer?
Yeah, Mom does that. And I think maybe you can see it still. Yeah, it's a bit hidden, but here, you see, there used to be an oven.
Okay.
And in the old days, people from the village would come here, especially at Easter time, to cook a special cake, which is called flan, flan de Pâques. And everybody would bring his cake, just
to bake it,
bake it there and sit, have a glass of wine, sing, chat.
Is this owned by your grand?
Yeah.
So it's just like you open it up for everyone to use.
Oh yeah, that was in the old days. We never did that, but mum remembers when they did that.
So not anymore?
No.
Because everyone has ovens now.
Oh, now it's the modern world.
Yeah.
People can share some of
the
moments together, I think, unfortunately.
Okay, through the door.
Back to the... And the wine cellar.
Did you do this?
No, Mum did that, I think.
Wow.
This is my granddad's wine cellar.
Wow. It's huge. This is... so amazing. I'm speechless. Look at all the parrots.
I think it's interesting that you should see that, you see, because it's very typical.
Yes.
It's very typical of the,
for you guys.
The architecture here.
Yeah.
Très bien.
Vite. Elles feront cuite.
Vite.
Il faut un quart d'heure, 20 minutes, le temps qu'on mange. Le foie.
One was oysters, and dish two, foie gras, and bread.
Another fish, white flesh fish.
Filet de... C'est un peu comme le merlan.
My potatoes that I cut. And this is...
Veal.
Veal.
Veal, yeah. roast veal.
Lovely.
With some...
With mushrooms, which... Champignons, mushrooms, girolles.
It's the called
Girol.
Uncle George is bringing out wine bottles
1985, older than you.
Way older than me. I cannot have any more. I haven't even finished the first one.
You have a sip just to taste.
Just to taste. But I'll pass. French, they have to have their cheese. So look at
them. They are French. Must
have cheese. I am stuffed, but it's cheese. We're having a little walk in the garden. I had a little nap earlier on because
you're recovering.
Yes.
You've missed the coffee. You've missed the coffee.
Oh, there was coffee?
Yes, yeah. Yes, there was coffee. Okay. But you can have coffee and cake when we come back.
Okay.
So we decided to have the cake later on.
Yeah.
And we decided that the sun was so beautiful we had to go out. And all this green. Oh
yeah, beautiful. Look at that. Huge garden. Well, you guys have to be here to enjoy this. It's so nice. Uncle George salad patch. The thyme. A little bush there. So we're out of their garden, which is that little stone bricks over there. And we're just walking down the pavement just right outside their house. And check out the view. Look at that. The sun is out, so it's warm and cool at the same time. And everything is still green and a bit of yellow. Chickens over there at the neighbor's house. It's a nice walk, yeah. I could live here. Auntie Edith is Auntie Odile's niece. So, but she's not here, she's in Beijing. She stays there and works there. So this is her house, just right outside this one. And the garden there that stretches all the way back. It's like a big nice house and we might be coming here for summer. So a little further from Auntie Edith's house is the canals. And if she was here, she'd take out all the little canoes and you can go rowing in the canals. So they want me to take a picture of them right now, so that's what I'm gonna do. Mill, yes?
Le moulin.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This one.
Oh, ça y est, le voit bien.
The one that Auntie Odile did. So this is was a school many years ago before you were born?
Oh yeah.
And Mum went to school into the other one that we're gonna show you.
Nice. So many stories. Behind the houses and everything.
It's
like
touching
that.
To think that she was here as a little girl and she's always lived here.
This is Auntie Odile's school.
When she was a child.
When she was a young girl. What year was it?
What year was it? 1947. Mum was born in 1937. She's 77. You see?
That's the school. This place, the school reminds me of, you know, the Madeline. Hey guys, so I'm back home in Hatfield. So yesterday after the walk, we went back to have some cake, orange cake, really nice. And then we took the train back to where our apartment was in Paris. And then woke up at like 6 this morning to get the 10 o'clock flight, which was mine, which got delayed to like 10:45. So I kind of missed my first class at college today. yeah, my plan was to come back just in time for class, but I missed it. So yeah, I just finished unpacking and here means work, back to reality. So I'll see you guys another time.